poker player. It's the sixth annual event, like I say, Monday, August 7th. There's all sorts of cash prizes, a chance to win more than $30,000 in cash and prizes, including a seat valued at over $5,000 to get into the SHRPO $3 million guaranteed championship. There's also going to be a couple of $1,000 bonus payouts. And, of course, Jeff Conine is also known as Mr. Marlin. And the Hard Rock is a great facility. So ConinePokerClassic.org is where you could get more information. And like I say, there is no better cause I can think of than Joe DiMaggio's Children's Hospital. They perform miracles there, and they certainly need your support. All right, what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break, and then we are going to be talking message out to the bros. We got the bro basket, and we'll be talking to the director of marketing, James Grasty, about bro basket. They've got all sorts of great gift ideas for those folks like myself who are racking our brains for good gift ideas all the time. So you don't want to miss it. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Cinderella story, out of nowhere, a former greenskeeper now about to become the Masters champion.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole!
I rap fly. Call me Chocolate Thunder, and I got good two going four strokes under. Get out the way if you want to go play, because I give it my all every single day.
Have a lot of cash because I sing my parts.
And we are back in time for one more quick message from our sponsor, Labor Finders. If your business needs industrial workers, or if you're looking for work, you got to call Labor Finders. Labor Finders places for temporary or temporary to hire opportunities for skilled, semi-skilled, or general labor positions, such as plumbers, electricians, concrete workers, forklift operators, hospitality, office clerical, and so much more. Labor Finders has almost 200 offices nationwide. Near here in Boca Raton, they have offices in Homestead, Miami, Fort Lauderdale, West Palm Beach, and in Jupiter. So if you need legal insured workers, or if you're looking for work, call Labor Finders toll free at 800-864-7749. That's 800-864-7749, or visit laborfinders.com. Back, one of my favorite bands, the Allman Brothers, and talking about brothers or bros, we all have those situations, whether it be a birthday, a Father's Day, a holiday season gift, graduation, you name it, for the guys, not the girls, and you just don't know what to do. Well, I found a place where it can be made very, very simple for you. So to find out a little bit about the Bro Basket, we're going to go to the director of marketing of Bro Basket, none other than James Grasty. James, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm sitting here planning out my next trip to Niagara Falls after that lovely review of it.
I feel like that old Abbott and Costello, you know, slowly turn, you know, step by step. But, Niagara Falls. And there were some beautiful golf courses up there as well. I did not have time. When I travel with the wife, she would kill me because that's what they do. But but what a beautiful place, and you just don't think about it anymore. That was kind of the old fashioned honeymoon capital of the world back in the day when the world was a bigger place than it is today. But I mean nothing like travel. But let's talk a little bit about gifts, because when it's right around gift time, I often talk about different products and bring in people who come from different companies that manufacture different products. And you know, year after year, we typically have the same friends. Of course, we have the same relatives, and you always got to scratch your head. You just don't know, you know, the guy that has everything, what do you do? And when I heard about your company, and obviously I know that's kind of how it all got started, and you're going to tell us about it, but I hate racking my brains. I can't stand going to the mall, especially in the holiday season. there's got to be an easier way, and I guess you developed it. So why don't you start out a little bit with the story of how and why the Bro Basket began?
Yeah, so it all started as like a classroom idea in an MBA program class here over at Cal State Chatham Islands in little Camarillo, California. And one of our classmates posed the question. She said, oh, it was a story. And she said, my fiance got me some flowers and I want to return the favor. And she said, I want to send you some flowers. And he said, that's ridiculous. Everyone will laugh me out of the place. He's like, why not a bucket of beer? She said, all right. And so she looked up, you know, can I send a bucket of beer? And she couldn't find it. It doesn't exist. And so that's kind of how the whole idea started. You know, we continued on the idea in the class. We all got good grades. But a couple of us thought it really could be something, you know. So we worked for like another year or so and turned it to a real business and launched a website back in December of 2014. And here we are, you know, almost 3 years later, and we're doing great. And we've expanded our line from a lot more than just buckets of beer. But we just started offering shipping a cold bucket of beer to somebody. So that's our new high-tech stuff we're doing here.
Yeah, that's for the person that just really, really needs a cold beer. You got to ship it to them immediately. They don't even have time to put it on ice. But I have a question for you. You mentioned about shipping the beer. Did you see in the news this past week that there was a story and there was photos to go with it? Somebody was on an airplane flight, and he actually checked through baggage one can of beer, and it actually went through the system and came out, you know, in the luggage area on the carousel.
Yeah, I mean, me personally, I fly a good amount and travel a lot, and I actually bring my liquids bag full of mini bottles of, you know, alien bottles of booze. But yeah, I did actually see that story, and it was on the luggage thing, right?
Yeah, that was very, very, very cool, I thought. So I have in front of me one of these Bro Baskets that you're kind enough to send me, and I do this with whatever products. I want the inspiration when I'm talking about it. It's right in front of my face. So obviously, since we're the golf and travel show, this has a golf theme. So why don't we talk a little bit about what you have for the special golfer that you need a gift for? Let's talk about that category.
Yeah, currently we kind of have two gifts that are golf-related, although we're big on customization. You can always customize your own from scratch, and so you can kind of add kind of whatever you want to a basket, whether, you know, it's, you know, a couple of golf balls and this and that. But that particular basket, you know, we have, like, tees and golf balls, and that Div Pro is a really cool multi-use, like, divots and tool for scraping your golf shoes and stuff. Mm-hmm. I personally use all this stuff when I go golfing, and we have a cool golf towel and stuff, so I don't golf that often, but when I do, I'm always using some Bro Basket gear.
Yeah, which lasts you faster, the bottle of scotch or the sleeve of golf balls?
It's a scotch, of course. I'm always in a tree or in the rough or in the highway somewhere. So.
That's a good question, though, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we covered, you know, the golf theme. So what other kinds of themes are popular with the guys?
Most of our themes kind of revolve around, you know, drinking. You know, we do sell alcohol, beer, wine. And so a lot of them are, you know, like a whiskey sampler is one of our best sellers. You know, Bite of Bourbon, Ultimate Gift for Men is a bunch of different cool craft beers that we kind of curated. You know, Cali Craft Samplers, a bunch of California craft beers that we kind of put together in a little sampler. So a lot of them are all kind of drinking related. You know, they got your Bloody Marys and things like that. But we are working on, you know, a whole new line of gifts that will have more defined themes as far as, you know, golf or, you know, sporting, you know, kind of stuff. Or we got some cool NFL buckets and things like that, too.
Now, when you first started, and correct me if I'm wrong, I at least know back in the day there were issues sometimes in shipping certain kinds of spirits to different states. You know, there's a lot of protectionism, like with wines, you know, they wouldn't let certain things come in and out. Is it still that difficult to get into all 50 states, or do you have no problem with shipping whatever it is anywhere?
Oh, no, we are fully licensed. You know, we have any license like a typical liquor store would. Mm-hmm. We only ship to certain states, so there's a lot we can't ship to. Mm-hmm. We always ship it with a 21 adult signature.
Right.
So you have to be 21 to receive it, which is kind of a pain in the ass for us and our customers. But, you know, we stay, you know, with the law there about it. So we did do all the homework and stuff and the legal footwork to be able to do this. It's not easy, but, you know, we just really want to be able to offer these unique gifts that no one else is really doing out there. And so we are, you know, willing to put in the work to kind of figure out the best legal way to do that.
Yeah, I don't think it's, I mean, obviously you don't want to sell to minors, and that's totally understandable, but I know that a lot of it was just protectionism, I think, from certain states to protect their own, you know, wine industries or brew industries or whatever, which, you know, that kind of stuff doesn't sit well with me. It's just doesn't seem right. So it's a shame that you had to do all that.
I can get in the weeds here with a lot of that stuff as far as, but basically, that's typically states we ship to with states that have wine laws on the books.
Right.
That's because there was a case some time ago about not being able to ship wine to certain states, and some people fought that in Supreme Court, and they won. And so we kind of fall into that jurisdiction where you know, we try to follow the laws as close as we can.
There must have been a big celebration from all the people that ship liquors when they were able to ship liquors. Obviously it's easy for them to celebrate, huh?
Yeah. Well, we like to have a good party.
Of course. So you said that you've been doing this since, what'd you say, 2014?
Yeah, December 2014, in the midst of the holiday rush, we launched a website, you know, and got a couple of sales. But, you know, since then, we've probably grown, you know, 1,000% or something like that. So it's been good to us.
Now, what's your end game? I mean, are you going to be bought by like Harry and David, like all these other gourmet food type things? I mean, it seems that they buy everything. Or do you think that you're going to just keep doing this forever and getting bigger and bigger on your own?
You know, I've been an entrepreneur, you know, since I was 18. I had a business when I was in high school. You know, I used to hustle CDs and stuff back then.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I have another business that's unrelated to the Brew Basket. And, you know, I'm all about having a lifestyle business, so I can have something that, you know, makes a decent amount of money, but also gives me the free time to travel, because I love to travel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm glad I'm talking to someone else that does. And, you know, that's kind of my end game, is just having free time and money to travel. Like, I'm kind of almost there with this, and so I'm happy, and I think my partners are mostly happy. And, you know, we're going to keep growing it to a certain point, but you know, we want to make sure we serve our customers good, and we make good gifts, and people are happy, and that we're happy, and so that's what's important to me. So if someone wants to buy us out down the road, like Harry and David, then so be it. You know, we'll take their money, but you know, our end game here is just, you know, to run a good business and to make people happy
and have a little fun while doing it, right?
Exactly. That's all you can ask for.
So now I'm looking at this from the individual consumer, you know, gift kind of idea. But obviously there are other ways that you can sell this too. I'm assuming that this would be great for businesses, for like corporate gifts, or maybe for golf tournaments or raffle prizes or things like that.
Yeah, we actually do a good amount of charity kind of stuff. We've given plenty of baskets to, you know, golf raffles, you know, dance offs, you know, whatever you can name it. You know, we've done a ton of stuff like that. But we do have a lot of corporate clients, especially on the holidays. You know, we have people that come in here and buy 150 Brew Baskets. You know, we've stuck them on a pallet and shipped them out.
Mm-hmm.
So we that's, holidays are really, always really good to us. And so it's some of our biggest time of the year with all these big orders and stuff like that. But
sure.
You know, it's the individual people, I think, is, at the end of the day, that order stuff, and they're sending, like, you know, get well soon or happy birthday, you know. You see, the kind of messages they send, and, you know, how happy they make people. That's kind of more fulfilling at the end of the day.
I could imagine so. Now, I've looked at your website. I know you said that you do custom packaging as well, but the ones that you portray on the website, what, about 14 or 15 different baskets you had there?
Oh, no, we have upwards of 80
more,
or 90
okay.
right now.
Okay, so I didn't see them all.
Like you said, you can customize your own with basically everything we have in our warehouse. And so, you know, the sky's the limit as far as what you want in a basket.
And kind
we'll
of
go run out and get something we don't even have here. We're nice guys.
Yeah, and you take a little sip just to make sure it's okay, right?
Well, we taste that,
of course. Yeah. Yeah. So, and can you give me a price range? Like, you know, if people are shopping in a certain range, where kind of it starts and where it kind of ends, from the smaller one to the very, very big one?
I think the least expensive basket we have, or gift we sell, is about $24.95. And then if you want to customize your own with a couple, a bottle or two of Blue Label in it,
mm-hmm.
I think the one of the most expensive ones we ever sold was, you know, $700 something.
Mm-hmm.
But an average gift around here, people spend about $100, including shipping to get stuff out. But we offer discounts and stuff, and we're also launching a whole new line of less expensive stuff. So, you know, we have stuff to fit anyone's budget.
Yeah, I think what people are paying for more than this really nice gift and this really nice product, though, is just the peace of mind to get it off your head when you're worried about what the hell am I going to get for somebody and all the trouble that you have to go through to find it and the shopping at the malls and everything else. You know, to just be able to go online and spend, you know, 5 minutes browsing around, press a couple of buttons, and it's all taken care of, and you know they're going to be happy. I think just for that alone, it's worth a lot of money.
Yeah, I agree. You know, it's important, you know.
All right, so now if people would like to take advantage of this, I know that we've been talking about your website, and I could tell them the website, but why don't you? Because it's yours.
Yeah, so the brobasket.com, pretty easy to find. Just Google us if you don't feel like typing it in. We offer, like I said, you know, upwards of 100 different, you know, options. You can hop on Customize Your Own, our number one seller, and customize what you want from scratch. Or, you know, yeah, we have a couple of good golf ones. We have, you know, executive with really good scotch. We have good whiskeys. Tequila is, you know, is sky's the limit. So, you know, best thing you do is just come check out the website and see what we've got to offer.
And what I could say is that with all these really neat golf things, if it doesn't help your game, at least you could drink your sorrows away, right?
Exactly. That's the whole idea.
Well, I really appreciate you coming on and explaining all this, because you certainly could do it better than I can. And it's a neat product. I really like it. And I know that our listeners would do well by going to your website, thebrobasket.com, and checking it out. So thank you for coming in, for calling in.
Yeah, thanks for having me. And I appreciate the tips on Niagara Falls.
There you go. Go check it out. All right. What we're going to do is we're going to take our last break, and then I got a couple of other tips on where you can go and where you can go for on the cheap as well. Some great deals. You don't want to miss it. So stay tuned. We'll be back with more of the Golf and Travel Show.
Get out of town before it's too late, my love. Get out of town. Be good to me, please. Why wish me harm? Why not retire to a farm and be contented to charm the birds off the tree?
And we are back. And I have got so much news for you and so many deals for you that I'm going to try and just touch on a couple of things real quick. And if you want to find out more information, then you can go research it, but at least now you'll know. South Beach, just south of here, Española Way, which is a really cool area of charming restaurants and shops and a couple of hotels. It just got refreshed, I guess, by the city of Miami. They put a couple of $1 million into it, so you may want to check it out. I've eaten down there before. It's very, very cool. And speaking of South Beach, Mango's, which became famous in South Beach, they have also opened up on International Drive in Orlando, and they're booming, they're expanding, and the fellow who is behind it, a guy by the name of Joshua Wallach, he is building a huge tower and a major entertainment complex. He bought, I guess, about 17 acres of land, and Mango's is just phase one. There's going to be this thing called the Skyplex Entertainment Complex Theme Park, and it is huge. So that iDrive area, it's always morphing, and it needs to be refreshed from time to time, and that's happening. So that's pretty cool. Norwegian Cruise Lines is going to be sailing from Port Canaveral, which is just north of me, up near the Melbourne area. And they'll be cruising from there to Cuba. So if anybody is looking to go to Cuba, it's I guess it starts maybe May 7th. You can go. Also, a hotel that I have visited, not stayed at, but visited, that's really cool, is now going to be part of Hilton's Curio Collection, which I like, because when I go to a cool hotel, it's always nice to also be able to get some points. And that would be the Hotel Del Coronado, where they filmed Some Like It Hot back in the day with Marilyn Monroe and Tony Curtis. A beautiful, beautiful hotel. Let's see. The airlines, good news, bad news. Qatar Air, their CEO had to apologize because he was critical of the U.S. flight attendants as looking like your grandmother. And the flight attendants in the Middle East are all young girls. And there's been fights going on that we've been documenting here on the show between the Middle Eastern airlines, which are getting major subsidies from the government, and it seems to be unfair competition to the U.S. airlines. And they've had issues, and this has only made it worse. So he had to apologize. Not a nice thing to say. United has upgraded their overbooking policies to try and not have to pay the $10,000 that they said they would pay people that they bump. So that's pretty cool also. Why don't we change gears and get into some deals before we run out of time? Let's see. First of all, if this is only if you're a teacher, but if you are a teacher, boy, are you in luck. We were talking about Orlando. The Grand Lakes property, which includes the Ritz-Carlton and the JW Marriott, they have a special going on right now through September 30th, teacher appreciation rate. So if you could prove you're a teacher, $128 at JW Marriott, $169 at Ritz-Carlton, Orlando Grand Lakes. I've never seen prices that low at that property, so you are in luck. And not only are you in luck with that, you may want to start planning a trip because coming up August 25th to October 1 is Orlando's Magical Dining Month. They've got over 100 great restaurants in Orlando that are all part of it. Down in Miami, they got Miami Spice. They've got a similar thing in Palm Beach. We'll talk about all of them when the time is right. But Orlando is a great town to visit, but the restaurants, you know, can be pricey. This is the time to do it. You're going to get special price fixed meals for both lunch and for dinner. Dinner, $35 a person. Some of my favorite restaurants are on this list. Some of the best restaurants in town. Places like Del Frisco's, Double Eagle Steakhouse, Fleming's Steakhouse, Morton's. Let's see, Spencer's for steak, the Grand Floridian Resort. You name it, on and on and on. I mean, just great restaurants that you would spend maybe twice as much that you can get great deals. Speaking of great deals, if you need a hotel and you're not a teacher, a place I have stayed at many times, played golf at many times, Reunion Resort, great place to stay. Rooms, a one-bedroom villa starting at $139. You got to book it by July 26th. You'll find that on Travelzoo. You know, they have full kitchens as well for the $139. You can also get two cocktails is for free as part of that. And you can fit up to four people in the one-bedroom place. They also have two- and three-bedroom villas starting at just $30 more. So if the whole family is going, it's a great deal. Found on Travelzoo. And like I say, you do have to book this by July 26th, so do not waste time. As always, with our discounts and deals, we typically start close and go far. So we're in Florida. We'll stay in Florida. St. Petersburg Beach, a four-star hotel at half price. The Kimpton Hotel Zamora. $179. That's doesn't sound that cheap, but trust me, St. Petersburg Beach is a beautiful beach. It's always highly rated and wins all sorts of awards. And this is for a king suite or a queen suite. You can also get a two-bedroom suite at $329 per night. You get a discounted resort fee of only $15 instead of $35. You get a 20% discount at the restaurant on property. So good deal for $175. And Kimpton Hotels, they've got their happy hour where you get free wine and sometimes discounted hors d'oeuvres every evening. So I always like staying at a Kimpton for that reason alone. Speaking of wines, a little bit further up the road, the place that I have stayed and played golf at, the Chateau Elan in Georgia. It's a winery as well as a golf resort. It's beautiful, and you can drive there. It's 45 minutes north of Atlanta. It's not that far, or, of course, it's easy to get a flight from Florida to Atlanta. You have until August 15th, only $169 a night, and that's for Sundays through Thursdays. It's $30 more on Fridays and Saturdays, but you get a $50 a day resort credit to use at any of their six restaurants, their spa, or golf. $169 and $50 back per day, that's a pretty good deal. Another place that I have stayed at and enjoyed not long ago, a city that I love. It's a little bit warm this time of year, but it's a great town and a great foodie town and a history town, and that would be Charleston, South Carolina. The King's Courtyard Inn is a beautiful, quaint kind of a hotel that's right on King Street where they've got wonderful shopping. And again, Charleston can be very expensive in season, especially a nice hotel like this. But Sunday through Thursday, a standard room starts at only $129 a night, and that includes breakfast and Wi-Fi. So not a bad deal. Also found on Travelzoo. Going a little further, a place I've not been to, but I would like to go to, and that would be Bermuda, the Fairmont Southampton. I've stayed at Fairmont hotels before. They are lovely. I believe that this is a very nice property. They're billing it as a Zika-free zone. So if Zika worries you, if you're thinking of having a baby or if you're pregnant, you may not want to go to places where mosquitoes are more frequent and Zika can happen. But, of course, Bermuda can be very, very expensive. But from November through March, $189 a night at this beautiful resort. Other dates slightly higher, as well as upgraded rooms are on sale. There's a two-night minimum. And again, I found this on Travelzoo. It's about a 50% savings. Bermuda is very expensive. That's why Dan hasn't been there. I'm waiting for them to invite me. Also, Rome and Athens, six nights with flights via Tripmasters on Travelzoo, starting at $759. And that's in November is when you can get the lowest prices. Other dates are slightly more. You got to book it by July 26th. And last but not least, a place that I've been told is one of the coolest places to go to. Not everybody is hip to it just yet, but Vietnam, 10 nights escorted, including flights. Ho Chi Minh City and Hanoi and a couple other cities as well. $1,249. You got to book it by July 21st. These are September and October dates priced from Los Angeles. But you can, of course, depart from other places. I am going to be traveling quite a bit coming up. I have a trip planned. I'm going to be driving from Colorado to Arizona, playing some golf in Albuquerque and in Tucson. So I'll fill you in on that. And I am also going to be playing some golf in Thailand, actually. So unfortunately, you may hear a couple of pre-recorded shows while I'm on the road. But the good news is when I'm back, I get to tell you all about it. And it's always good because, like always, the good, the bad, the ugly, and everything else. The best way to know where I'm going and who our guests are going to be is to go to facebook.com/thegolfandtravelshow. Like the page, and I update usually a day or two before the show who the guests are going to be because I don't always know myself. And, of course, if you don't listen live on Friday at 7 on WNN 1470 and 95.3, listen to WSBR on Sundays. The show runs at 6 o'clock, 7:40 a.m., 96.9 FM, and 103.9 FM. Can't wait to talk to you next week. We'll have more stories from the road and some great deals. You won't want to miss it. The Golf and Travel Show. Talk to you then. My suitcase and guitar in hand, and every stop is neatly planned for a poet and a one-man band. You have been listening to the Golf and Travel Show, hosted by Dan Chu. Heard live every Friday, 7 to 8 p.m. on 1470 WWNN, and replayed every Sunday from 6 to 7 p.m. on 740 a.m. WSBR. Visit the show on Facebook and tune in next week. If you are in South Florida or traveling the world, hit 'em straight. The opinions expressed on the following sponsored program are strictly those of the host, guests, and callers, and not necessarily those of the station, its staff, management, or sponsors. Me and my old lady ain't been getting along. Things don't get better. I'll soon be long gone. This situation is driving me insane. Somebody touched my curtain hat and my walking cane. Staying healthy is difficult. What nutritional supplements should you take? What foods are best for you? What health practitioner should you see? You've got health questions? I've got health answers. From heartburn to hemorrhoids, pain to pimples, carpal tunnel to the common cold, gluten to gallbladder, and gingivitis. And all points in between. I'm Dr. Bob Martin. Tune into my Sunday talk show at 10 o'clock on Talk 1470 WNN. You use Tearless Baby Shampoo because it's gentle on your baby's eyes. You make sure his toys don't have any sharp edges. You always test the bath water to make sure it's not too hot. You taught her what to do when the smoke alarm goes off. You make sure she wears a helmet when she rides her bicycle. You put on his sunscreen, even when he's embarrassed his friends will see.
You do so much to keep your child safe, but are you using the right car seat for your child? Is your child facing the right way in the car seat? Is the seat too big or too small? How do you know when it's time to move your child into the next type of seat? Car crashes are a leading killer of children ages 1 to 13. Protect your child's future at every stage of life. For information on the right seat for your child, visit safercar.gov/the right seat. That's safercar.gov/the right seat.